a typical house in a regular suburban town. But here, a family's preparing for the end of the world. A German Mauser and P-38 from World War II, a 12-gauge shotgun, a 40-caliber pistol, and an AR-15. Weapons and ammunition are key.
If we're carrying this out on the street for some reason, all hell broke out and it's, you know, end of the world type situation. You can't walk around with these guns here.
Keith Perscura, a certified NRA instructor and owner of two businesses, stores food and supplies to help him survive no matter what disaster might hit.
Breakdown of government is one thing that a lot of people are preparing for now. We're facing possible pay delays for Social Security. I don't believe I'm going to need any of this kind of equipment for that, but you're going to have a lot of Americans that are kind of upset.
The 37-year-old is among thousands of American preppers who would rather be ready than sorry. RT spoke with the founder of the Preppers Network from inside his truck.
Not so much political, but more economic. I see people every day lose their jobs and have to rely on food that they've had stored up previously to live on that food just because they've lost their job.
Gas masks, bulletproof vests, canned food, tents, and helmets fill basements like this one. A prepper's survival bag is not a typical first aid kit. It includes things like a parachute cord, a body heat retaining space blanket, a survival knife, a meal ready to eat, and bagged emergency drinking water. According to preppers, one must also be ready for chemical catastrophes or a large-scale terrorist attack.
Contaminants landing on top of you, you'd have a couple pairs of gloves on. Your feet would slip into a chemical-proof boot.
If you're going into an unknown situation, you want to have one that's fully encapsulated to where you know 100% sure that nothing is going to get through to you.
A variety of walkie-talkies are ready for use if the communication network shuts down.
WA2MOL, KB2DXA.
Yeah, W4BOS.
On the other end of the line, Keith's father, who is actually in the next room.
WA2U.
A police officer for 25 years, he's now retired. His main pastime is operating a ham radio. For him, communications will be key if disaster strikes.
The tsunami and earthquake in Japan a couple months ago, amateur radio played a big part in that, in providing emergency communications when everything else failed. And the big hurricane in Haiti a couple of years ago.
There's one scenario he fears more than others.
If there was some kind of a nuclear fallout, radio wave propagation would probably, for all practical purposes, cease.
Around $10,000 is the hefty price tag for these supplies. But to preppers, it's not just 10 grand sitting in a basement. With uncertainty taking over the U.S., they say those who seem paranoid today may end up being the smartest tomorrow. Anastasia Churkina, RT, Somerville, New Jersey.